not so many big stones here. Obviously the big stones down next to where the wire is, so everything gets caught up in. Stand on the rope every time. Got the dog tag on the end. So if I'm anywhere up and tight to a rail, instead of putting your foot on it. Good eye. The main thing is keep the rope nice and level. And coiled up nice when you're fetching it in, and then the next one will throw out easy. Oh, you're pretty slow down here. What's it about 9 o'clock? Did the duck just take their foot for a while? Well, I don't think they've got us caught. There's a heron. It was there when I came over that area. Sitting next to them reeds. Nice on a canal somewhere. Obviously we don't have many canals up in northeast. Just go around where there's some swimming areas. Like down Durham by the river, where the old baths used to be. That'll be good. And the little jetties to launch the rowing boats off. There'll be all sorts in there. Mobile phones jumping out the pockets. Surprising what it is, you get a lot of junk. You get a lot of junk and crap. It also peaks. Oh, it's like me first find. First find, there we go. Woohoo! Woohoo! Part of a break. Part of a push bike break. Woohoo, that's fine. Always take your rubbish away with it when you've pulled it out. Don't chuck it back in, that's stupid. Put it to one side, or put it in the hedgerow when you come away from it. Bikes and all sorts, and left there. Maybe some bikes, maybe that's off the flood waters, isn't it? Stupid people swimming, they just leave the stuff lying about. Just think of others, tax it out to be careful. This is a good one. So I make a puff going in. Going up higher than this distance. Oh, there's a football. There's a football, I don't know if you can see on the other side, stuck in the reeds. It's starting to rain. It's a forecast for rain in Durham. Supposed to be doing it, I ain't good. Thank you. if you get a bit of flood water coming down, this will be all well in the water. No, not them houses up behind the creek. That's in great flooded. Another one getting stored. Oh, look, it's a magnetic. Oh, huge. For a couple of minutes. I think I'm ready to be in charge. I know you're not going to get brass, copper, gold, silver and things like that, right? But, you know, it's just doing a little bit of a thing and finding out some of it. And, oh, there's a staple. I found a staple. Okay. I'll put that down there next to the wire and put them in the staple. The power is smug. A bit of bike. Well, this paracord's good stuff. It is. It's really thin. It's a military grade 550 pounds pulling. You know, for 50 pounds, that's a canny bit of cables, magnets. 150 kilos, which when you think it, it's a lot of weight that. I had a bit magnet fishing first time out. I'm getting stuck once. Joys. I think the idea is when you come with this here, fetch some gear in case you get wet. There's a hind getting wet. Oh, that's pulling through. Pulling through. Just listen to that river. It's rustling by. No care in the world. What easy is that? Well, No worries, but that was nice and peaceful next to the river. No noise, and so there's a 50 road, you know, if it comes, pick it up. You got a lot of sea trout and salmon in this river. Oh, I might have some of there. I might have a bit of wire. That is a bit of an old key, a big old key, maybe key to the castle. That would have come up under here, key would have been out there, big door key. Woohoo! Could find cannonballs now, so that's it. Try again. Oh, big rock. It's going because it took all the line. Put 30 metres of line on. It's a long way to chuck a heavy weight. Green rope. You can get it on all different colours. Well, I thought like if it's bright, if it do snap or come off, you can have a bit of idea where the magnet is. Of course I've got the spare one, I could chuck them in the same area. I've got to keep them well apart from each other in the buckets. You get very angry. There's a fish just rose. Just over there. Oh, there's another one. Little trout. Ah, they're too magnificent, very angry, very dangerous. And if you have your fingers in the way, it's a broken finger, not a nip, it's a broken finger. The power of these magnets. Well, I might have been pulling up some Ray-Ban sunglasses or something, or somebody lost them, or mobile phones or something. It's early days, yes. Poor people in Durham don't have much stuff like that. Yeah, I think I started myself a nice little hobby with this. Magnet fishing. So look on my website, I'm on YouTube. Go on to Bill Meadowfield Boy